The earthquake effect adds a visual punch to your video and helps with the overall flow of the music and the video together. In this video, I'm gonna share with you two different ways to make this effect and show you how and when to use it. All that coming up. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest DaVinci Resolve tutorials put out. All right, so this effect is pretty cool. It's super simple, so let's just do this. So I have this clip right here. It's of a football player. He does a spin move on a guy and he breaks a tackle and just avoids it. So this is where we're gonna do our first jitter move. It's gonna be like the vertical jitter. So you see that I have this section cut out right here. This is where a piece of action happens, right? He stops and he's about to do a spin move. You want the jitter effect right there because it's gonna add a little extra punch to this. First thing you want to do with this little section you have cut out here, your little action section, is you're going to left click and hold, and then click and hold Alt. So do that and drag it up. Now you see it duplicated a clip. So nothing different happened. There's no effect. It's still the same until you click on the top one and you drop the opacity in the inspector tab down to about 75. If you don't have the inspector tab open, click on it, open it up, drop your opacity down, make sure your clip's highlighted. So now that you've done that, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to your position, you got your X and your Y. You're gonna keyframe your Y position and you're gonna move it up just a little, right? So you see that there's a little overlap, but nothing crazy. Move ahead one frame, go down to about negative 20, move next frame, move up to about 20, go down, same thing, all the way over this clip. And it's just this subtle shake. It doesn't have to be perfect, just has to look good. So this is what it looks like. Now, of course, you can adjust accordingly to what your clip is. It doesn't have to be the exact thing I'm doing. So now we're gonna move on to the second variation of this earthquake effect. So this part here is where he breaks the tackle. We wanna add a little more oomph into the whole thing. Once again, I cut my section using the razor tool, and I grab it, hold left mouse, and then hold the Alt key and drag it up. Same thing as last time, drop the opacity down to about 75. And this time, instead of going up and down, we're gonna move all around. So as a general rule, he's blowing through this tackle. I want him to first move forward so it looks like, you know, it's a little more epic and intense and all that stuff. So we're gonna go to our position and we're gonna keyframe it and we're gonna go to the X and we're gonna just move it forward a little to about 20. About 20, and just keep moving forward. I'm using my arrow keys, by the way, to move forward. So then I'm gonna move back, but then I'm gonna move a little up on the Y position. And then forward again, and move it down to about 20. Just stay within like the 20 to 30 range. Positive, negative 20 to 30 on your X and your Y position. Somewhere in that, because if not, it's gonna look really weird if it's a little too much. So you keep it going, just moving it all around, doing that good stuff. And it's that easy, literally. So to make this effect work, you first need to have music that goes along with it. Every time you have this earthquake effect, you need there to be a pretty hard, bassy beat, because it's gonna emphasize this hit or this step or this action that you've just done. Maybe someone just got punched. It makes the viewer be able to feel what just happened to them. There it is, the earthquake slash jitter effect. So what do you think we should do for 1,000 subscribers? We are about to hit that on this channel. I wanna do something special. Let me know if you have any cool, crazy, or awesome ideas. Put them in the comments below. But as usual, the video on the top is all about smooth transitions in DaVinci Resolve and how to make those buttery smooth transitions. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you're gonna like. But until the next one, peace.